I want everyone here to close their eyes and imagine a world devoid of color. It's hard, isn't it? Now, open your eyes. We began in a journey in a world devoid of color that kind of looked like this. Not because color didn't exist as a concept, but because we couldn't perceive it. This was how we saw the world 500 million years ago. So today I'll take you on a journey from primitive animals that kind of saw the world like this into the complex eyes that you and I have today. And we'll talk about at the end what that means for the future of artificial intelligence. Now, vision as we know it today would start evolving 500 million years ago through a Cambrian explosion of life. This explosion would take these primitive creatures that couldn't see color and evolve them into millions of different kinds of animals that would see the world in remarkably different ways. In the camera culture group at the MIT Media Lab, we were asking the question if we can simulate the Cambrian explosion using artificial intelligence. We're trying to use AI beyond just chatbots to digitally grow these trees of life. Let's be more precise. What we're trying to do is mimic biological principles of evolution in AI so that we can go from these complex eyes all the way to those primitive organisms that we see over there. Now, this is actually a different approach, but as technologists and inventors, what we want to do is we're interested in building technologies that can help us study the evolution of eyes, as well as create the next set of, create the next technology that will lead to the next artificial intelligence. With that, we can kind of fill out these gaps that we see over here in our understanding. Also fill out these question marks, which may be extinction, animals that have gone extinct. And also realize how we can change how we design artificial intelligence. To create this artificial explosion, we need to first create the building blocks of eyes and intelligence. We start with a primitive eye over here. And this primitive eye consists of a photoreceptor that can kind of sense light, something that we saw on the first slide, and some neurons that are able to kind of take this light and act. So the animal can now move in this environment. We can create an artificial version of this. So we can create an artificial version of this with artificial eyes and artificial brains. And we can see how this animal might see in a computational world. It doesn't see much. But let's see if we can evolve this further. So now what we're going to do is we're going to co-evolve its eyes and brains, kind of like how evolution did it. So after five generations of evolution, the building blocks get stacked together in very interesting ways. We can kind of see more information here. This agent can see where the sky is and where the ground is. Now, this is actually what a worm sees. And even though this is severely limited to us, but it actually gets a lot of information. Now it can tell where the sun is, which is very useful if it wants to figure out where the food is. So let's evolve this a little further. After 20 generations, we start to see an emergence of a pinhole eye. And if you look carefully, we can actually see a couple of things. We can see the shapes of nearby things, and we can see the textures of different objects. This pinhole eye is one of the most important inventions, not just in the history of our own eyes, but in history of cameras. In fact, this was first conceptualized in 5th century BCE and later formalized by Da Vinci. So what is really interesting here is that without explicit programming, our agents have developed and invented something that humans took hundreds of years to invent. But something interesting happens when we run our evolution further. Some of these agents end up getting an evolutionary defect, which is why they start to see the environment, they kind of start to see the environment in a very dark way. It doesn't really see the environment. Why is that? This is actually one of the trees that we haven't seen, because these animals that developed a pinhole, a collapsed pinhole, got extinct. So this is actually why we don't have pinhole eyes and why the cameras that we see aren't pinhole cameras. So how can we see better when there's a physical limitation of how these agents are evolving. See, the agents have invented a better way to see now. Now, some of these agents have gone extinct, but some of them are more relentless. What they have done is they have figured out a way to see using a lens. Now, these AI agents have created a lens mechanism by expanding their pinhole, actually going reverse in the evolutionary timeline to let more light in so that the images are brighter, and then form a lens such that the images are sharper. Now, that is something what a modern camera is, or a human eye does. Let's let this go on a little further. So once the agents have figured it out, they can actually keep evolving their lenses to create sharper and sharper images. And we can finally see that we can see the textures on the wall, and these agents can see and navigate in a much better way. So let's see the whole journey of our creatures. So we start off with these light-sensitive eyes, and we move on to these cup eyes that have enabled directionality to these agents so that they can now navigate to where the sun is, kind of like a worm. Then they evolve into a pinhole eye, something a very important invention in human and biological history. But some of them go extinct because they take the wrong path. Other agents develop a lens, which means now they have eyes like modern eyes. So going back to the tree here for a minute, what I omitted was that we have been evolving this tree for a particular task. The evolutionary task here is to figure out what the difference between food and poison is. What if we want to evolve for a different task? There's a lot of evolutionary pressures. Maybe you want to evolve it for the agent to navigate as a maze. Maybe a room like this or a complex building. What will happen then? Will the eyes change as a result of the intended behavior that we want? So we ran this experiment and we saw that this is the case. When we evolve for more tasks which require detection of fruit versus poison, we get eyes that look like human eyes. But when we evolve for a different task, we start to get eyes that might look like eyes of an insect, compound eyes. So we see very different ways of viewing the world as a function of what the behavior is. Now, I want to zoom out and show what we have done here. We've computationally evolved vision and intelligence for some higher level behavior. But the pinhole eye has inspired us for years, especially Leonardo da Vinci, to create the camera obscura, which then led to cameras and self-driving cars. So what I'm really excited about is how we can go and make this further. We can start to enable a Cambrian explosion of artificial intelligence. Can we find cancer biomarkers in the body by inventing new coding mechanisms using properties of light that are actually invisible to us? Can we invent non-invasive brain imaging techniques by co-evolving molecules and imaging techniques? Or maybe we can do something else. Maybe we want to explore the space. And what we want to do is figure out what the atmosphere would look like in a completely different planet. So while the research is a step towards this vision, this is really a call to action for neuroscientists, engineers, artists. Because to enable a Cambrian explosion of artificial intelligence, it will be inventive, but we must make sure that it's human-centric first. Thank you.